presents. Cost me $50, everything I had in the world.
If you had that $50,
then I'd get it on and you'd lose her.
Yes, you would lose her. I'd lose her. Let me see what you've got in that bag.
What would you want with this?
I might have to buy something. I'm a peddler, ain't I? I buy and I sell things. Let's see what you've got in here. Well, let's see. It might pay you plenty of money, but let's see. Oh, it looks like a fine French hot water bag. I'll tell you, pay $8 for it.
Well, that ain't fair. I only paid $3.50.
Like I said, $8, I pay you $8 for it. Oh, my, look at these, mighty dainty.
That was for our wedding night.
I'll pay you $22 for it. All right, $22.50. Well, let's see here, what else we've got. Oh, my itty dainty ankle brace.
Oh, for our wedding night.
It don't fit you so good. I tell you, I'll pay you $15 for it. Let's see now. We've got $8 and 22 and 50 is, and 15 is 45.50.
45. That's all. What about some more?
Right.
You ever see one of these?
What you doing with one of those? You got to deal for somebody?
Not to me. Just a bunch of funny. Just a bunch of funny pictures.
That's all that you think it is? That's much more than that.
Come in, everybody. Where's the miller?
On the other side of the house. House is going on.
Don't handle things like that. It's too dangerous.
Just a girl in a pink tie.
That's all you think it is?
Hey, did you see Lori?
Yes, from the other side of the house. How's it going over there?
Hey, Judd. Here's one of those things that you were looking for. The little wonder.
Oh, yeah? How much you want for this?
$3.50.
Yeah? That's a lot of money. I got me a little idea that it just might be worth it.
Let's see. $3.50 from him and $45.50 from you. Well, that's $50, ain't it?
No, $1 short.
Darn! I must have figured wrong. How much for the rest of the stuff in this bag?
$1.
Sold. You know what that means? That means I get 8 of 1 and you're a loser.
Oh, now you wouldn't do that to me, would you?
Oh, wouldn't I? Wait till I tell her Paul who I got the money from. Then maybe we'll see who's smart and who's dumb.
Well, young fella, you certainly buckled me.
Well, that ain't fair.
Going for 50
3-day bellyache.
Scare the living locks out of my head.
I knew how you was kicking up some capers while I was off in Kansas City, Mo. I heard some things you couldn't print in papers from fellas who've been talking like they know.
I only did the kind of things I am. Sort of teach you what faithfulness can be. For me, just stories that will
I go and sold my last while well, I cut out all shenanigans. I save my money, don't gamble or drink in the bathroom down in Flanagan's. I give up lots of other things the gentleman never mentions. Before I give up any more, I'm running up your intention.
I bet you don't remember drinking me. everything you ever done, every word you ever said. I can't think of nothing else. Can't you see? Can't you see how it is? Yeah, I ain't good enough, am I? I'm just a hired hand. I got dirt on my hands, pig slop. Ain't fitting to touch. You're better, so much better. But we'll just see who's better, Miss Laurie. Then you'll be sorry, you're so free at your ass. Why, you're such a fine lady.
Are you threatening me? You trying to tell me that if I don't allow you to slobber all over me like a hog, why, you'll do something about it? Why, you're nothing but a mangy dog, and somebody ought to shoot you. You think so much about being a hired hand? I'll tell you something that'll just rest your brain, Mr. Judge. You ain't a hired hand for me no more. You just pick up your stuff and shoot. Why have you got better ideas than that? If you don't come on my place ever again, you hear me? I'll send your things any way you say. But you so much said a foot past my pass, you ain't gonna send the dog for me.
You said your say. Bung it on yourself. Can't help it. Do anything about it. I told you how it was. You wouldn't listen.
Laurie, have you seen Eloise? She's gone again.
Oh, Will, will you do something for me? Will you go find Curly and tell him that I'm here? Oh, I've got to see him. I want to see him.
Well, why don't you just turn around and look at you, crazy woman?
Oh, Curly!
Looks like you found yours. I gotta go find mine. Now, what on earth is wrong with Eloise? Why do we cry?
I'm afraid. Wait for my life.
I've been toadstool.
Oh, Curly, don't ever leave me.
Oh,
Ah, the lonely gypsy must go back to the open road.
Where's that going? Many people know me.
Ah, Angel, there's a man here who loves you like nothing ever loved nobody.
Yeah, how did that come?
A man who will stick to you forever. And that is the man for you, Will Parker.
Oh, yeah. Well, I like Will a lot.
He's a fine fella, young and strong, young and handsome.
I love him all right, I guess.
Oh, and you love his big brown eyes and the way his mouth wrinkles when he smiles.
Do you love him too?
I love you for the way you would make my Angel Annie happy. I will show you how we say goodbye in Persia.
That's goodbye?
There's an old saying in Persia. One goodbye is never enough.
Hey!
Oh, Will, Alan, that's when we say goodbye.
Oh, Will, I was just coming to say goodbye to you, too.
Oh, no, you don't. That's not bad.
Now, Will, you take good care of her, and you take care of him. Lucky fella. I wish I was marrying her instead of you.
Don't seem to make no difference, Harley.
That's true. I must be going. Will, don't go to the family and that be off.
Didn't you say you was going?
Yes, the lonely gypsy back to the open road. Will, goodbye. One goodbye is never enough.
You ain't gonna think of old Featherman no more, are you?
Of course not. Never think of no one unless he's with me.
Then I'll be with you forever.
Even if you never go away. Even if you never go away on a trip or nothing, can't you once in a while give me one of them Persian goodbyes?
Persian goodbye? Let me show you an Oklahoma hello.
Yeah. They're coming upstairs.
Yeah.
Oh, are you the Troy Curly Shimmery? I wish to
you. Oh, it's a good old fashioned custom. Never hurt anybody.
Please.
You get out of the way.
It can be rough, isn't it?
Oh, you quit gabbing about it. Scat, scat.
It seems like this time the men ain't got no meat for woman.
Well, this time the men ain't got no meat for men.
Yeah, but who wants to be dead?
Far retirement would be the way I am.
What'd I do with that?
just me.
Sure as you're born.
Been taking Judd over to Dave Tyler till the morning.
Alive?
Lori, honey. This year's 48, I'll be the federal marshal, you know. Thinks I should give myself up. Tonight.
Tonight? But your train leaves in 20 minutes for Claremore.
Best thing would be for Curly to go on his own accord and tell the judge.
Why, you're a judge, ain't you, Andrew?
Of course, but,
Well, then tell him and get it over with.
Wouldn't be proper. We have to do it in court.
Well, let's not do it in court. Do it here. And say we did it in court.
We can't do that. That's breaking the law.
Let's not break the law. That's just thin.
Boy, a fair trial without locking him up on his wet knife, and that's the long and the short of it. Now, I gotta ask you this question. What's your plea? That means what you do.
Oh. Well, it always been coming around the pond, bothering Lord. And I said that one day I was.
Quiet. Don't let your tongue wobble around your mouth like that. Now listen to my question. What happened tonight that made you kill him?
Well. He cut at me with a knife.
And you had to defend yourself.
Right. And first.
Never mind it, Brother Morris. The plea is self-defense. Now, wait a minute. Is there a witness who saw this happen?
I got a funny feeling about this. Funny, funny.
You're gonna have a mighty funny feeling when I tell your wife you're carrying on with another woman.
I ain't carrying on with no one.
Maybe not, but you're gonna feel mighty funny when I tell your wife.
Yes,
well,
but...